I'll cover problem 91 of Erodo. It is based on Newton's rings, but Newton's ring, don't look it as a Newton ring and think that it is out of it may be out of syllabus. No, Newton ring is a special case of a thin film interference where you have two. Normally this is how you solve the problem. You have glass slabs and in between you have air. Now in case this glass slab, instead of glass slab, you can have a curved kind of a surface. You can have curved surface which is a lens, or you can have a curved surface which is a cylinder kind of a thing. It can be a cylinder. So in that case you will have parallel fringes, and in case of lens, because it's curved all through, you will have circular fringes. That is the only difference it makes. The whole concepts and principles are similar in both the situations. Now coming back to the cases of Newton rings, here generally it is said 10th ring, 10th dark ring, 11th dark ring, 4th bright ring, and then we get confused here which formula to apply, whether it is twice n minus 1 lambda by 2, or it is twice n plus 1 lambda by 2, and lambda of course is there. Which one should we put? What value of n should we put if we are given certain ring, if we are given 10th ring or 11th ring? How to decide on that? I'll cover that aspect also, because that is very crucial. Making a mistake there makes the whole problem, makes the whole answer wrong. In this problem, what we are given is two lenses are combined in such a way that one is a concave lens and another is a biconcave lens, biconvex lens. It can be a plano convex lens and a plano concave also. We are given the power of the combination of these two lenses, and we have to find out when they are placed in such an arrangement, what is the radius of the 10th dark ring in this situation. First of all, we should know the simplest of the cases, and from that simplest of the cases we can just extrapolate and solve all kind of problems. Now simplest of the case of Newton's ring is this, where you have a lens. It can be plano convex, plano concave, it doesn't make any difference to my rings. It only makes the difference what you are given is the focal length, or if you are given the power of the lens, from there you have to find the focal length, if from there you have to find the radius of curvature. But if you are given the radius of curvature, if you know the radius of curvature of this surface, whether it is plano convex, biconvex, whatever, that doesn't make any difference, because we are not concerned with the reflection from the top surface. We are only concerned with the reflections done by these two surfaces. Because why these two surfaces and why not this? These two, because it is these two surfaces which enclose a layer of a very thin film. It can be air, it can be water, it can be oil, it can be any other material. And interference, for interference you required thin film. For thick film there is no, you don't get noticeable pattern. So reflection from here and here doesn't produce that kind of interference which you are looking at. So that is why I'm saying, whether it is flat, whether it is convex, it doesn't make any difference. So just for simplicity, let me have it like this. Even if it is curved, I repeat, it doesn't make any difference to me. Certain basic things we should know. Here light is coming normally, and first reflection takes place here. It gets reflected by this surface, and suppose it is coming slightly inclined, first reflection is here, and the second reflection takes place from the lower surface. Those details are not required by you for solving this problem. So light ray is entering almost normally, and it hits almost normally, and this radius appears very small here. And you will say, how can ray go in that direction? Ray should have gone in that direction. Actually, this radius is required to be very large. It is almost a flat kind of a surface. So only thing is just to derive the formula, I have taken a small radius. so that I can show this curvature. Otherwise, its radius is very large. This film has to be very thin to get the interference. Now, at any distance from the axis, you have a radius and you get rings which are circular. The ring's pattern is that central ring is dark. It is not ring, it is spot. Then you have followed by a bright circle, then followed by a dark circle, which I will show like this. This is important to know. Rather than simply memorizing the formula, you will end up writing the wrong number of the ring. Until you go through what I am trying to explain is not given in that detail in books. The lecture will become lengthy, but I will, until I explain this, I am not doing justice to this problem. Then comes the bright ring, then comes the dark ring. Now, numbering of the rings is very, very crucial. This is, let me draw at least three so that I can then write the formula and explain the formula. So these are the rings, and this is another one I'll draw. Until I take two, three, it is not, it doesn't become easy to explain. Now, this is how the rings will appear, fringes, because it is a curved kind of a symmetrically curved surface. Had it been a cylinder in place of the lens, a cylindrical object, then you would have obtained parallel kind of fringes, like as you obtain in the normal situation, thin film interference, what you read in the books. Now, this is the speciality of Newton ring. Why this central spot is black? Why it is black? The path difference here is effectively, I will not write t is equal to 0, I will say t is tending to 0 to write the formula. Now, to write the formula for the path difference, you have to know that when there is a reflection and the mediums are different, there is a phase difference called pi, or path difference is lambda by 2. When it is traveling in a denser medium, and here is a rarer medium, and reflection takes place like this. There is a rarer medium there, part of it goes there also, and this is the denser medium. There is no phase change, but when it goes from rarer and it is dense, and reflection takes place in the rarer medium. From rarer it was going to dense, this is how it was happening. Here the phase change of pi happens, or path difference of pi by 2. Now, one thing you have to keep in mind in this situation, normally we are given the material is same. We are given normally the same material, but I think JE exam is capable of making it more complex, and they can change the whole concept by having materials. Right now I have material mu, and this is mu air. In this situation where mu in between is less than this mu and mu A is same, there is only a phase change of pi, or path difference change of lambda by 2. Why? Because here it is denser medium, no path difference happens, but here it was traveling from rarer to denser. This is dense, this is a glass slab beneath. So you are coming to denser medium from rarer, so here the path difference of lambda by 2 or phase change of pi happens. So path difference between the two rays just because of reflection is lambda by 2. This path difference had already happened. Now, another path difference takes place because the rays, this ray which goes back from this surface and the other ray which comes from this surface, they travel different distances. And if this distance is t, approximately both are same, it is twice t is the path difference due to the distance, different distances traveled by the two rays. I am completing the complete theory of the Newton's ring, and especially the numbering of the rings I will cover. Then I'll come to the nitty-gritties of this problem. So those who know the theory, they can straight away skip and go to the subsequent level of the solution. Now, this is the path difference. If there is medium, suppose the medium is mu, any medium is there, I put. So this is geometrical path difference. Geometrical. But in optics, you have to take optical path. So geometrical, this is the extra path it has traveled twice t, but optically it will travel twice t into mu. This is the medium. Let me write it as mu m. It can be water, it can be air. If it is air, you put mu is equal to 1, but have this habit of putting mu. So one is this path difference, and another path difference is because of this, that is lambda by 2 is the path difference because of the reflection. So this is reflection, and this is because of the different paths, and combined you get the net path difference. Now let us make a table, which is very important to understand, to link the number of rings. Nth ring, fifth dark ring, what kind of formula you will use, or third dark ring, what kind of formula you will use. This table should be there in your mind broadly. Now a table, when I draw, let me write first the central part, and divide the path difference. This is path difference. One will happen due to the reflection. I straight away write lambda by 2, which will happen in all the cases. And another is twice t mu m is path because of the path difference, different lengths covered by them. Now for this, and let me write here some of it, some of both. I will write the total. Let me remove it. I'll rewrite it. This is total. So this is due to reflection. This is due to lengths. Means different lengths. And let me draw this table and I'll do the total. See what is happening at the central thing. This path is already there, lambda by 2 is already there. This change is happening, whether it is central or first or second or any ring. So this path change, this much has happened. Now central, ideally t should be 0, but now you will say, when t is 0, how can you say that there are two reflections? A moment t is 0, how can you still say there are two reflections? So first of all, when we say t is 0, t is technically not 0, because there will be some particle, some gap. So I said t is tending to 0. Even if you say I make t 0, even then you will not fuse the two materials together. Until the two materials are same, made together, fused together, they will behave differently and give different reflection. So t is tending to 0 here, so this is tending to 0. So path difference at the most will be slightly less than lambda by 2. It can be slightly less than lambda by 2, or if you make it 0, it will be lambda by 2. So it is lambda by 2. I write plus. It is not given in books anywhere, but this is how you should analyze it. So it is, but it is tending to 0, so it is tending to lambda by 2, so it has to be dark. But this is a dark central region. Do you call it a first ring, or you do not call it a first ring? Let us see. When we apply the formula, you should be very clear, and language of question should be seen also very clearly. Now come to, as you move in this direction, now let me draw the expanded view. I was somewhere here, and the path difference was lambda by 2. The thickness was almost 0. The t was almost 0 gap. As I start moving in this direction, I reach I keep on increasing t, this remains lambda by 2, this doesn't change, but this keeps on increasing. So when it is increasing, when this becomes lambda by 2, this will increase from 0 twice mu t, value will increase from 0, it will start increasing. So first will be lambda by 2, not lambda, it will first become lambda by 2. So it becomes lambda by 2. So you get total lambda, so it is bright. And this is bright first ring. So total path difference for first bright ring is lambda, but you will write twice mu t is equal to lambda by 2. If it is first ring bright, I'll come to the formula also. First bright ring, and here what did you write for the first central, I will call it, you will write t is equal to 0, this twice mu t m was tending to 0, that was the central. Now let us move further. Numbering of the ring I will come to. So as the value of twice mu t increases, from lambda by 2 it will go to lambda. So now this remains, so this was the first circle. When I say central, after central I start counting. This is the first circle. This is the second circle, this is the third circle. So one is the circle, another is whether bright circle or dark circle, those numbers are then again taken differently. So in the problem it can be said 10th fringe, it can be said 10th dark fringe, it can be said 5th fringe or 5th bright fringe, 5th dark fringe. So until you do it like this and you have this clarity, applying the formula may give you straight away, applying the formula may give you the wrong result. Now I just come to second. I'll do only up to second, say third. This is lambda by 2. This increases and becomes lambda. So it becomes 3 lambda by 2. So since it is 3 lambda by 2, it becomes dark. In between you get mixture, means there is no fixed dark and no fixed white and bright. They are just spread over. So there is a point where precisely it is lambda, lambda by 2, 3 lambda by 2. But both the sides you will have darker, but the shades will keep on decreasing. And second circle was this. What is second circle actually? First circle, this is center, first circle, second circle is first dark ring. If I say ring, this is a disc. This is a disc. And this is ring. So it is first dark ring. Dark ring. First dark ring. And the requirement of first dark ring, what is value of twice? Don't write twice mu t as 3 lambda by 2. See here, twice mu t, mu t m, twice mu t, sorry, twice mu t is equal to lambda for the first dark ring. So naturally for the 10th dark ring it will be twice mu t is equal to 10 lambda. That is one way of writing. Now with this you should know the formula so that in exam you will not have this much of time, but this should be in your background, in background of your mind. The formula is how that formula also comes. The formula is twice mu t plus lambda by 2 is equal to n lambda. If I write, this is for bright, this was the requirement for the bright, because the sum total, I am not writing this as n lambda, I am writing combined, the combined lambda by 2, 3 lambda by 2, lambda and 3 lambda and twice lambda, this will be twice lambda. So it has to be integral multiple of lambda, and n will start from 1, because this zeroth is not taken, it is a disc. I am talking about rings. First ring is at lambda, second ring is at twice lambda, that is the total that is the total. So just be clear, here I am referring to the total path difference. I am writing n lambda, so it becomes twice mu t is twice n minus 1 lambda by 2 for bright. And straight away put the value. If it says 10th bright ring, you will put the value of n as 10 here. So twice mu t is equal to twice n minus 1 lambda by 2 for bright, and value of n has to vary from 1, 2, 3, 4. Value of n cannot be 0 here. You can also check with twice mu t. Twice mu t is this. So twice mu t for the bright ring is, this is center, the first bright ring is here. Twice mu t has to be lambda by 2 for the first. Just put n is equal to 1. You get 2 minus 1 is 2, is 1, lambda by 2. Twice mu t is lambda by 2, first bright ring. So the formula is twice n minus 1. Don't use twice n plus 1 and start writing from n is equal to 1. If you use the formula twice n plus 1, you have to use n is equal to 0. This is what I wanted to cover. That is why I wasted so much of time. But if you don't know that, the whole purpose of doing the problem gets defeated. And for the dark, it becomes twice mu t. Similarly, I get is equal to n lambda. So here the n is the nth, is the ring number of that pattern. Means it can be dark. So if it is 10th dark ring, I'll put 10 here in this formula. If it is 10th bright ring, I'll put 10 here in this formula. But it has to be 2n minus 1. It is n lambda. And in both cases, n is from 1 onwards. It is an integer, positive integer. This was about the Newton's ring and the path difference and the formula. Now coming to another crucial part which is required for solving such problems. So for solving such problems, it is becoming lengthy, but these concepts were required. Now this is the radius of the ring, and one is the radius of the surface. Don't get confused between the two. And this is the thickness. There is a straightforward formula, twice RT is equal to R square. This you should just memorize. It should be on your tips. Every time don't derive it. You can also derive it simply. What is this value? This value is T. So what is this value? This value is R minus T. This is R and this is R. Just apply, this is right angle. So R square is R minus T whole square plus R square. So R square is R square plus T square minus twice RT plus R square. This gets cancelled. T is very small. T is small. So T square we ignore. So twice RT is equal to R square is this formula which I am saying. It's very, very important. So once you know this formula, it becomes very easy. This formula is applicable when one surface is flat, another is curved. But there can be varied situation. There can be a situation like this. These two curved. So here what happens? Here basically you have T1 and T2. So and the radius is same. I'm discussing larger things in this problem also. I'll come. So radius is same RR, but here the radius of curvature of lens may be R1 R2. You know T1. For T1 you apply this formula, twice R1 T1 is R square, and for twice R2 T2 is R square. R is same for both the cases. So you get T1 is equal to R square upon twice R1, and T2 is R square upon twice R2. In this case, T1, T2 gets added. Here you will see T1, T2 gets subtracted. It can be made more complicated like other Erdo problems where this crown is slightly grinded and made flat. Originally the lens should have been like this. it is grounded and flat surface just penetrates into it little bit. Try to do this, you can easily do. If this is h height which has been grounded and this is at any particular radius, so just then solve from the imaginary surface of the original lens, you will get t. That is from the original lens, had it not be crowned, just draw the dotted line, draw tangent, t you will get using this formula. This is h, so effective t will be t minus h. What is the value of h? Value of h you can find if this radius given as r0 and this is h, so you can find h based on r0 using this formula. You can find t based on r, same formula. So this is your mother formula, that is what I want to say. So now I know my mother formula, and with this almost all the problems can be solved. Now here what I am getting is two thicknesses. One is the thickness, because if had this surface, I draw tangent to this surface, and this is my t1. So for t1 I have relationship with r1, so I have twice r1 twice r1 t1 is equal to r square is the radius. Now come to this, let this be t2. Now t2 is twice r2, t2 is r square. Effective distance of air film is t1 minus t2, so t1 minus t2 is r square upon 2, 1 upon r1 minus 1 upon r2. This is my effective thickness. Now coming to the other part of the problem, in the problem you are given power of the combination of lens. Now there also more complications can be made. It is given in air, they can give you in certain medium, this combination placed in some certain medium, you got the power. So just think of that also. If I include that, it becomes very lengthy. So right now the power is given in air. So what is power? Power is 1 upon f1 plus 1 upon f2. What is f1 upon f1? Is this lens maker formula, is mu minus 1 upon r1 minus 1 upon minus r1. Both the radius are same. I'm not covering basics of this formula, you should be knowing. Always put the value of r with the sign r2. This is r2 actually. r2. So 1 upon f1 plus 1 upon f2 is mu minus 1 into 2, 1 upon r1 minus 1 upon r2 is the value of the power, which is nothing but phi. So if I write here, phi is mu minus 1 into 2, 1 upon r1 minus 1 upon r2. And what was the value of t1 minus t2? Value of t1 minus t2 was r square upon 2, 1 upon r1 minus 1 upon r2. So just divide or just put the value, so you get this relationship of t1 minus 2 is effective t effective, and put the value of t effective twice mu air, t effective is the gap, is equal to, we are talking about 10th dark ring. For the dark ring the formula was n lambda, and n is the number of the ring, number of the dark ring. So use this formula, t effective is n lambda upon twice mu a, and value of t effective is this, value of r1, 1 upon r, I can do it fully, r square upon 2. What is this value? Is phi upon twice mu minus 1. This is the value of t effective, and if I put the value of t effective here, it is twice mu air, t effective is r square upon 2, phi upon twice mu minus 1 is equal to n lambda. This 2 gets cancelled, so get r square is equal to twice mu minus 1 n lambda upon phi mu a, And if I take square root, just recheck the answer. Means I'm doing it so fast in so many things, even I may make a mistake. But the method is same. Mu a I have written, in case you insert water or any other thing in between, divide by that. But be careful. That liquid which you are inserting has to be, if these are same, and this liquid which you are inserting has refractive index less than both. If that liquid has such a refractive index that it is mu 1, mu 2, mu 3. It is mu 1, it is mu 2, it is mu 3. And they are in certain order. Then you have to be very careful to rework on the whole thing. Whether that phase difference of lambda by 2 is happening in this case, it depends in what order we arrange different refractive index. So that care has to be taken, because that will again alter it. One problem of Iridov is on that, where the refractive index I think is increasing. It is, I think, maybe after this problem. So I hope the concepts are useful.